Over the weekend, I was out in Dallas, Texas to check in on 2022 Oregon wide receiver commit Stephon Johnson Jr. at DeSoto High School, but there were a lot of different prospects at that school, lots of talent to check in on and talk to. And one of the guys that I checked in on was 2023 wide receiver Jonte Cook II. He does have an Oregon offer, and he recently released a top 12 to start off the month of September. Schools included in that top 12 include Florida, USC, LSU, Texas, Ole Miss, Alabama, Ohio State, Notre Dame, Texas A&M, Oregon, Penn State, and Oklahoma. So tons of really big schools in the picture here early for Cook, but I was able to talk to him and kind of wanted to just talk about the latest in his recruitment, where Oregon stands. They obviously made that list, talk about why they made that list and kind of where Oregon stands with Cook rather. So, talking about why Oregon made his top schools, he said it was because the team's playing well and they're putting the ball in the air. And he feels like he has a good relationship with wide receiver coach Brian McClendon. As far as specifics there, he feels like he's a relatable guy. McClendon is almost like a friend to him, and he has a lot of knowledge of the game. So that's obviously helping the case anytime you have a guy who can talk the X's and O's with players. And, McClendon has his fair share of NFL wideouts that he's produced throughout his coaching career, previous stops at Georgia and South Carolina for McClendon. And then you also have Stephon Johnson, who I mentioned at the beginning of the video, who's at Oregon. But I asked Cook if he's making, a push, talking to him, if he's in his ear about the Ducks. And he said it's every now and then that the two are talking about Oregon, but it's not like he's making a huge push or anything. So that's kind of what we hear a lot about peer recruiting sometimes. But, at the end of the day, these guys got to make their own decisions. So I think that the relationship that we see with recruits is pretty – it's just genuine. They're a lot of the times I talk to guys about peer recruiting and they really just say, we're talking about, the relationships with the staffs at these schools, scheme, what are they telling you? What are you kind of hearing as far as, how they're going to take care of you, plans they have in place. So sounds like Johnson, isn't pushing too hard for Cook. And I think that kind of comes with the mutual respect between recruits to really just, you have your process and you do your thing and I'm kind of here to help. That's usually what I hear. But another interesting part about Oregon and Jonte Cook, I asked him about that win over Ohio State at the beginning of the year. And I think that his answer here that I'm about to read really kind of puts into perspective, how big of a recruiting impact that win can and perhaps already has had for some recruits. So asked him his reaction to Oregon's win over Ohio State. This is what he had to say. It actually shocked me. I'm not even going to lie. I did not think Oregon was going to beat Ohio State. So when they won, it opened my eyes and I was like, well, they for real, they are for real. So, Ducks, showing that they can contend with those big programs. Ohio State was one of the finalists, maybe not finalists. I shouldn't say that. One of the top schools. Ohio State was one of the top schools that I mentioned for Cook earlier in this video, included in that top 12 that he released in September. So that's the Oregon angle. But like we see with a lot of top tier recruits, especially these 2023 guys that are still very early in the process, there are tons of big schools that are in the picture. When the recruiting trail opened back up this summer, Cook was able to take some visits, took some trips out to Texas, Texas A&M, Alabama, Baylor, Oklahoma, and TCU. So a lot of that, staying close to home for a lot of those visits in the Lone Star State. When I was talking to him at DeSoto, he was wearing a Texas backpack. So, take that, do with that what you will. So I had to naturally ask him about the Longhorns, where he visited this past weekend after DeSoto's 45-0 win over rival Cedar Hill. So I asked him about Texas and kind of what he's liking there. And it really comes down to Steve Sarkisian for him and the play calling that he's seen this season, with Texas's offensive explosion. That's really what's standing out for him. Just the way that he schemes guys open, especially for a wide receiver. You see how Xavier Worthy is playing early and making a big impact. Xavier Worthy, obviously a name that Oregon fans should be familiar with, seeing that, they were definitely in the thick of his recruitment before he committed to Michigan. And then ultimately ended up at Texas. Let's see, what else do we have here? So I already talked about Texas, and then that Bama visit was pretty big. So as far as, you know, some of the schools that he's hearing the most from. He has that top 12, but it sounds like there's a group of contenders here that is prioritizing contact with him, has the most frequent contact, and those schools are Texas, no surprise there, USC, Texas A&M, Alabama, Ohio State, Oregon, Florida, and LSU. So still a bunch of schools in the running here, but it's good to hear Oregon in that company of schools that are talking to him the most frequently. Like I said, he was in Austin over the weekend, so that's a big visit for him. And then moving ahead, looking ahead, he has some other visits that he wants to take, looking like he's trying to get out to Ole Miss this upcoming weekend on the 23rd, Texas A&M for their game versus Auburn on November 6th, and then he's also trying to make it out to Baton Rouge, Death Valley to check out an LSU night game. So my biggest takeaways from this, you know, I think from what he told me in our conversations, I have a full story up on kind of his recruitment up on SIL American. That's Sports Illustrated's national recruiting coverage. So make sure to check that out. I think that the schools that are really standing out the most for me, for him, based on our conversations, was Texas A&M, Texas, and Alabama. You know, he said, I took that Bama visit and Bama is Bama, you know, regardless of what happens. So, you know, Alabama is obviously going to be a contender for any recruit that they're going after. So Oregon definitely has some work to do here. Brian McClendon, you know, he brought in multiple SI99 wide receivers last year, and Dante Thornton and Troy Franklin, who have seen playing time this year. Franklin seeing the most playing time of the freshman wideouts for Oregon so far this season. But I think that there's, you know, plenty of time for Oregon to make up some ground here. And, you know, getting out to Eugene is going to be really critical for this staff to get Cook on campus. And that was one of my big takeaways, I think, from this weekend that I spent in Texas. I was there Thursday, Friday, I should say, so not the weekend. But it's just, you know, these guys, they can take visits to these Texas schools, or these other schools in the South so quickly versus flying oftentimes, you know, across the country or halfway across the country, in Oregon's case with Texas, you know, on a pretty short notice. You know, play your game on Friday, and then you have a short drive to Austin, or you're going to College Station. So just the proximity, I think, you know, it's not a deal breaker for Oregon, I don't think, not in a lot of cases, but just I wanted to kind of talk about and mention the how easy it is for some of these guys to get to the schools that are closer to them in the SEC, in the Big 12, maybe not so much with Texas, but in the ACC for some schools as well. We know how much talent is out there and that neck of the woods as well. So Oregon has their work cut out for Jonte Cook the second, but they're definitely in a good spot due to that relationship with Brian McClendon. If you're still watching the video, kindly ask you drop me a subscribe to the channel. It really helps me keep doing my thing, covering the Ducks. It only takes a couple of seconds out of your day, and it's totally free. So go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter at mtorisports, name right there on your screen. And also check out more of our Oregon Ducks content on ducksdigest.com. And we're on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Ducks Digest. That's all we have for this one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.